done. So this is a chapter on three modes. Three modes being Maya. And here the King Nimi receiving the Nav Yogendras. And the Shloka says, I'll declare to supreme wisdom, the best of knowledge, knowing which this is attained to the supreme perfection. And more Shruti Phala, this is called Shruti Phala, the benefit of hearing the Bhagavad Gita, or this chapter particularly. In fact, there is something called Gita Mahatmya. Gita Mahatmya comes two places. One thing by Shankaracharya, we read that in the first day. And in Padma Purana, every chapter has a Gita Mahatmya. You will be shocked how much benefit is there in understanding every chapter. How much spiritually we are blessed by the Lord. He is so happy that you are trying to understand his letter. For every paragraph of the letter, that is every chapter, he gives. You see, what is one chapter for us is, if you write in Sanskrit, just one paragraph, so 20 lines, that's it. And so much blessing for reading every paragraph. So what is Krishna saying? You'll attain the transcendental nature, spiritual nature, which is like my own nature. And one is not born. You'll have no rebirth in the world and no dissolution. You'll be any disturbed by even pralaya or anything. Okay, totally taken care. Sarvayonishu, the Krishna started the teaching of this chapter. Sarvayonishu kaunteya murteya sambhavateya tesham braham. Brahma Mahadyoni, Aham Bija Prajapita. Krishna said, I am the father of all the living entities. That's very loving, sweet from the Lord. He is the father of all the living. He is a claims himself to be the father of Sarva Yoni. Yoni is the term equivalent of species in Sanskrit, different forms. But true, the focus is more consciousness than the physical form, but it is equivalent. So 84 lakh yonis are being discussed in the Shastra, equivalent of. Now, science also agreed that many number of species are there. Yeah. Sarva yoni shikanteya murteya sambhavantiha tehatram brahma mahadyoni aham bija prajapita. I am the seed giving. So we don't agree to Miller's theory, Darwin theory, and that will open a big Pandora box, but I am ready to handle it. All the species questions I designed. It is not accidentally evolved, and it doesn't look logical also. I can take the topic in a big way. Made possible a birth and metal nature, and that I am the seed giving father. I have a lot of presentations on science and spirituality. Here the time doesn't permit. Sometimes you stay with us, we will teach you all. Sattvam rajas tama iti guna prakriti sambhavah nibadnanti mahabhavo dehe dehinam avayam. Material nature consists of three modes, goodness, passion, ignorance, Krishna introducing. But he started with the soul. You see that he talked about the soul having different forms because of different situations that Krishna is equally loving, but different forms are more suitable for different kind of consciousness. Three modes, goodness, passion, and grief. When the living entity come contact with nature, he become conditioned by them. But the Lord is not conditioned. The material modes are below him. Just like in a jail, the king comes to the jail, he's not under the rule of the jailer. Rather, the jailer offers prayers to the king when the king comes. So when Krishna came, all the devatas, Brahma, Shiva were offering prayers to Lord Narayana or Krishna. They're all offering prayers to him. He's not controlled by the jail. No way. Nobody can control him. He's above he's the creator of Maya. You are being controlled by Maya. He's a controller of Maya. You're being controlled. And these three ladies are like Sattvaguna, Rajaguna, Tamaguna, like Katputali. When you acquire infection, Rajaguna, Tamaguna, we are supposed to jump according to that. We lose our freedom. My natural healthy behavior is taken away when infection comes. I'm sneezing. That's not my healthy behavior. So that when the infection comes in, it takes over and we, like a katputli, we are jumping. We lose our freedom to act. Now, I do not want to play these videos. I'll play that separately. This is a beautiful video, which I did share probably or may not share. Three modes in YouTube. Roshan, it can be located in YouTube. This is there in YouTube. Three modes and similar faces you will see. There's so many videos.
Yes, Prabhuji, I've seen it.
Yeah. So please share it in the group so they can watch it in the group. They love it to watch. Huh? I can show them, but after the class, because on the record, I cannot show because this will be copyrighted. You know, it will they are using music in the background, which is copyrighted. It will create problem in YouTube. So tatra sattva sella, the mode of goodness being purer than the others, is illuminating and it frees them from all sinful reactions. Those which are in that mode develop knowledge, but they become conditioned by the concept of happiness. They get conditioned by the concept of happiness. You get some kind of a satisfaction. I remember in my college, some professors, I don't know how many of you had an experience, some professors are there and they're very pious, very calm, but they don't take to spiritual life. They're very happy. They're very happy, you know, being more intelligent and wise. Sattaguna is like a computer without virus, works with full power. Rajaguna is a computer. Rajaguna is computer with virus started. Tamaguna is because it doesn't even switch on. That's Tamaguna. Okay? Tatra swatam nirmalatvat prakashakam anamayam sukha sangena badnati jnana sangena chanaga. Eliminating if it's all, so those which are in the mode develop knowledge, but they become conditioned by the concept of happiness. Okay. That is, sattvaguna is very pure, like bodily temperature, 98 degrees is sattvaguna. Rajaguna is 101, the disturbance is there. And tamaguna 106, almost death, madness. Now let us, this I can show you how the animation. The sattaguna person is always smiling, but he is doing some hard work. What is the hard work he is doing? When bad desire comes, and I told you, I took, in fact, many of my colleagues were telling, don't say no non-veg, people get hurt. Because 90% eat today, it's true. But please don't get hurt because, you know, sadhu will speak that. So I'm not saying you change your menu, but you know, if you have somebody sitting in Tilaka dress like this, he will still be vegetarian. You take your time, but please don't feel bad. So four things: intoxication, gambling, illicit sex, and meat. I took liberty to tell the meat. I generally we don't say because it's too early for them, most of you. But I take a liberty. I hope you don't take personally any offense at that. So idea is this, that it's not good to have. And these four things actually constitute the filter. No intoxication, no gambling, no illicit sex, and no meat. They constitute a filter. The moment a thought comes, which is actually breaking this four, cut it off. Then you'll always be smiling. Just like suppose somebody, you are having a public computer, somebody brings his pen drive to you. What do you say? First, I'm going to scan, then I'm going to watch. Put, allow the content. If in a hurry, allow things inside without scanning, then my computer is full of virus. You all know that. The same way, the mind also should filter. Take for even infection, same thing. Why are you filtering? Why are you taking? Some people say, thoda chalega tamogun, then I'm a standard answer. Thoda corona chalega. Nahi, nahi, nahi. So you should immediately strictly filter, not allow it to go inside. Thought you cannot stop. Nobody can stop thoughts. Thought will come. That's the thing, an ocean bubbles come from nowhere, from some lifetime. You might have cultivated some unwanted habit, so that desire may come, but it is still good to filter it off strictly. So the man who's smiling is doing a hard work. He is doing a lot of hard work, but it is not visible. Mentally he's doing. And good desire comes and encourages that. So you cannot be free from desires, but you have to encourage good desires. How do you know good or bad? This is the filter. No intoxication, no gambling, no meat, no illicit sex. Just like watching movies, it tends to go toward no illicit sex, because what is there? Just watching a lady all the time, like looking at her. Acha sabha. Then is Rajoguna. The mode of passion, Rajo, Ragatmakam Vidhi, Trishna, Sangha, Samudbhavam, Tam Nibatnati Kaunteya, Karma Sangena Dehina. The mode of passion is born of unlimited desires and longing, O son of Kunti. And because this one is bound to material fruitive activities, the person becomes, I want to achieve this. I want to. He's better than a person who is sleeping, that is tamasic, but he has some selfish desires and unlimited longing and is always envious and jealous of others. Not a good thing, but not bad, as bad as tamaguna. That is, I have actually video to show you, but I'm avoiding because of you wanted to record this. And now, this is Rajasic man. You can see envious, jealous. He's working hard. Tamasic fellow is sleeping in the classroom. Rajasic person goes to the class, but somebody that's better than him is jealous, envious. Not good. Why are you jealous? Congratulate him. Good. Why? So I put him in the both of them, good and bad desires do enter his system and harass him. Therefore, he has this envious and jealous. And he wants something. Sattvic person just wants knowledge. Rasic person wants money, power. And tamasic person just wants to sleep. There's a tamasic, drugs, intoxication. Tamastu agyana jamvedi mohanam sarvadehinam pramadalasya nidrabihi tannibadnati bharata. The mode of ignorance causes delusion of all living entities. It is the mode of madness, indolence, and sleep. And one thing interesting, you'll not be able to believe. All of us are tamasic in Kali. There's a Kalo Shudra Sambhava. Shudra was not a birth term. Shudra was a person. All the time cries. That is Shudra. And Brahmana is always happy and detached from this world. And via media, Kshatriya than the Vaishyas. The Shudra means he cannot follow any rules and regulations. Mostly sleeping all the time. And no samskara can be trained into him. Isn't it today, the situation like that? You take the youth today, can you teach any samskara? They will not like to listen anything. How many of people are in the teaching profession will agree? So tough to even take a class. Even 6th, 7th class, small, 10, 12 years, children are so difficult to manage today. Because Shudras, very difficult. They are not fit for actually education. And what education is being taught today, it doesn't need classrooms. That is, you can go to the field. Lohar business, how to bend an iron, why you're holding classes. Let them be on the field, they will learn. There's a whole classroom teaching is a failure of a setup for Shudra education. It's best for on the field. Let them learn on the field. This is Shudra. Cannot follow any rules and regulation. Good desires are there. But please, I'm using that term. Not take it by birth. It is by behavior. Bad desires, you saw again. So some friend says, we'll smoke, drink. You see the reality, 90% youth today smoking and drinking. They're Shudras. That's Shudra, definition of Shudra. Cannot follow any rules and regulation. In a Gurukul setup, they will be sent back home. Gurukul, they say, Guru says, I can't train them. They are so restless. So good, bad desire comes. Grows, and it does activity also. And good desire, it thinks about it. Thinking, feeling, and willing are three stages. Thinking, you get a thought. Say, a snake comes to the room. Thought. And feeling. Huh? And willing, you decide to do activities. Three stages and grows up. Good thought comes, he doesn't know the thing. He thinks about it, but doesn't know anything about it. Bad things he cultivates, so he's foolish. And he's sad all the time. Now, there are implications of cultivating sattva, rajas, tamas. Mode of goodness conditions one to happiness, passion conditioned to fruits of action, ignorance of madness. So goodness, we are happy. Passion, we are disturbed. And ignorance, we go mad. That's how it is. More, sometimes the mode of passion becomes prominent. So there, all the three modes are fighting with each other, defeating mode of goodness, something else happens. I took an example of mind is dragged by one of them. So we keep changing also, and not that we are in pure goodness, we are in mix. The three modes can be taken as three colors and something revolutionary now. The different shades are prominent in you. Based on that, 84 lakh species are there. 84 lakh species depict different color. And one species will fit one kind of color of your consciousness. Suppose, you know, the RBG, you can mix and make unlimited colors. 84 lakh shades of colors are there. Interesting. The manifested mode of goodness can you experience on all the gates of the body, 11% feel very pious, calm, peaceful. And mode of passion, increased by symptom of great attachment, uncontrollable desire, hankering into the end of a fucking very heart. Because heart is already victimized by some desire for honor, prestige, enjoyment, that is Rajoguna. But it does in a dharmic way, that's all. The Tamoguna, it does adharmic way, forgets all rules and regulations. This is Tamoguna, madness. Actually, typically, this is a situation today, very sad. 20% youth are addicted. Those who know the reality. Those sitting in utopian world, best of luck to you. But look at the ground reality. 20% youth are today into drugs. And this is the condition. Very capable boy, it's a very sad situation. Very capable person, he's physically, you see, looks totally fit, has good muscles in his body, sitting near a urinal after taking drugs. So unfortunate. Increase the mode of ignorance, madness, illusion, inertia, and darkness are manifest. The harassment of the mind is so much, he just collapses. When he dies in the mode of goodness, he attains to the pure higher planets. When it dies in the mode of passion, it takes birth among those engaged in fruitive activities. And it dies in the mode of ignorance, it takes birth in animal kingdom. So there's an implication of that. Okay? When you die in the mode of goodness, you go be among the great sages. Hey, Narada, great sage. When you die in the mode of passion, you take birth among those engaged in fruitive activities. And ignorance, you take go to animal kingdom or even plant. Some people say, once human, always human. You can't say like that. This woman always liked to be naked. Now there's a moment in the world, nudie movement. They like to be naked. Nudie beaches, nudie clubs. Yeah, good. Next life, be a plant, best for you. You can stand naked for a lot of time. Nobody will object. Some people like to eat meat, even though it's not encouraged in the Shastra. A tiger body will be better for you, no? Go. Eat, live you eat. Why you have to simply cook and so much energy wasted? And no sin. In when a tiger eats an animal, there is no sin. For you, there is sin. Because you had a freedom which you are misusing. You had intelligence to discriminate what kind of food you should eat. But you're behaving like an animal. You're not discrimination. Better become a tiger. Or worse, pig eats anything. Like in China, 5 viruses have come out already. You know that at least, and then sleeping. Let me not speak more. Some people say, why you speak about a table menu so much? It hurts so much. So I'll stop at that point. And sleep all the time. Some people, their BS body will be very good for you. You behave like an animal, then animal body is good. Karmana sukritasya hu. Satvikam nirmalam phalam rajasastu phalam dukkam ajnanam tamasa phalam. Acting in the mode of goodness, one is purified. Very nice. This is told in the later in the 18th chapter also. Sattvic activities generally are painful now. Just like getting up early in the morning, very painful. But later it's a great pleasure because it changes your moods. To say tomorrow morning there is your examination. Okay? And everybody is watching the cricket match. Again, this nonsense season started. So the people, they watch cricket match. Tomorrow your exam is there. So rasik means you'll sit all the time there. And next day you spoil the paper. So rasik is pleasure now and pain tomorrow. Sattva is pleasure now. You are addicted to cricket, but you don't go. I want to also see sixer. They're shouting. No, I have to study. Painful now. But you do very well in the exam tomorrow, pleasure tomorrow. Sattvic is pain to pleasure. Rasik is pleasure to pain. You enjoy and then you... And tamsik is not even in the cricket when you're taking drugs, which is very painful. And then he has a quick death. And passion resulted in distress and action caused in mode of ignorance resulted in foolishness. From the mode of goodness, real knowledge develops. That's the biggest problem people are having. I'm not able to concentrate. I'm not able to remember things. Yeah, because remembrance and concentration comes from Sattaguna, which you have to cultivate. Sattaguna has to be cultivated. Then your memory. And you're always happy, smiling. And you get, that's like that. You can read for hours. Sattaguna means you're actually hungry for knowledge in Sattaguna. And you say, I understood that. That is Sattaguna. For mode of passion, greed. But today the activities are rasic and they want to be sattvic. How can it be contradictory? They drink, they smoke, they womanize, they watch movies, they eat meat, and they want to be sattvic. Not possible. Therefore, they can't study. They don't study. They just cram. You give a book to sattvic man, voracious reading, will read for hours. And rasic man, you give the book, he will read little, but then he will be thinking about most around the world of his enjoyment. And tamasic, he will just sleep. That's it. He'll not study. From mode of passion, grief develops, and mode of ignorance, foolishness, madness, and illusion develops. So different people, you see that. Goodness, he was quite peaceful. Rasik, he was looking greedy. And Tamasik, he looks horror. Urdham gachanti, you cultivate Sattaguna, you go higher planet. You go to Devaloka and you can then go to Vaikuntha. It's very auspicious. Madhyate Rajasa means you'll stay where you are now. And Tamasa will go down to animal kingdom or lower planets. So you go up or you go down. Those in the mode of goodness gradually go upward to the higher planet. Those in the mode of passion live on the earthly planet. The mode of ignorance go down to the hellish planets. This is what it is. When you see that there is nothing beyond these modes in nature, the all activity, the Supreme Lord is transcendental to all these modes, then you can actually know my spiritual nature. Very nice. When the embodied being is able to transcend these three modes, he can become free from birth, death, old age, and disease and enjoy nectar even in this life. That's why I use this picture, I think, to invite you today. break free from bond. That's the target of this chapter. It's like, you may ask why you're talking Sattva, Rajas, Tamo, Guna. We are talking about spiritual life. This is material. Yes, but presently you're having temperature. It's good to know the temperature. So introspectively, and you know the best thing, you sit down for 10 minutes and try to chant Hare Krishna. You can come to know which mode you are in. If you are at that time attentively able to hear every word, Hare Krishna, you know, it's a litmus test. There's nothing to be very proud or sad. My condition, you don't feel any shy to doctor. It's 103 degree temperature. Why? Because soul is always pure. It's an infection of the body and the mind. So, but you should know where the infection is to purify. Why allow doctor to take temperature? Because then you take medicine. So break free from bond. That's the target we have. You want to come out of Rajas and Tamas completely. Is able to transcend these three modes, he can become free from birth, death, old age, and enjoy nectar even in this life. If you're able to transcend the three modes, you enjoy nectar even in this life. Every moment is a fun, happiness. Krishna has not made this troubles. Now, I would just like to see this video. They are having kirtan. This is not under Rika, under Kumbha, ISKCON kirtan, so it's not under. So ecstatic, the kirtan. This is my favorite kirtan leader in Vishnu Jana. I just remind myself to put the also in the group. This is from a Gita class at the end. So ecstatic, so much happiness, you see. And these people, Hare Krishna Mantra, none of them is from India, all except the Acharya. You see that how much happiness they're having at the chanting, how much happiness. And they gave their life, most of them gave their life to be part of this mission. And you could see in that audience, families are also there. In ISKCON, we have families also, grihasthas. Some people remain brahmachari, they wear saffron. Some people get married. Women generally all get married. Men also, some men get married. And you know, the lady were dancing with the child itself. Like that. Ashram, grihastha is also ashram. Provided they follow rules, it's an ashram. So here the brahmachari looking so handsome, so calm and peaceful. Oh my dear Lord, by what symptoms is one known who is transcended to the Arjuna said, oh, you can enjoy nectar even in the slice. So how do I come out of Maya? How do I come out of Maya? That's the target. What is his behavior? How does he transcend? How do I know a man who has overcome Maya? How is his behavior? How does it? And most important, how do I transcend? So what the symptom one who has not in Maya is, he does not hate illumination, attachment, delusion when they're present, not longs on them when they disappear. See, like unconcerned, being beyond the mental reaction, modes of nature, remains firm, knowing the modes are all active, who regard pleasure and pain alike, looks on a cloth, stone, piece of gold with the equal eye, whose vice and hold praise and blame to be the same, who is unchanged in honor and dishonor, who treats strength and foe alike, who has abandoned all fruitive undertaking, such a man is said to transcend the modes of nature. Then now, most important verse of today, Mamachu Avyavicharena, without any distraction, Bhakti Yogena Saivate, somebody who surrenders to the Lord without any diversion. Sagunana Samati Tetan, he can transcend the three modes. Brahma Vyaya Kalpata. So always your day should be packed with good activities, and best activities, devotional service. Then you can transcend the Maya. If you are idle mind, then devil's workshop. Hard working and absorbed in doing some service to the Lord whole day. Then you can Bhakti Yogena, you should have some challenge. Even spiritually, some challenge, some activity, you can totally be absorbed. Mavacha Vivacharena Bhakti Yogena Sevate Sagunana Samati Tetana Brahma Bhuyaya Kalpate. Engaged in full devotional service that does not fall down any circumstance, at once transcend the modes of mental nature, and thus comes to the level of Brahman. Brahmanohi Pratishtam Amritasya Sasyacha Shasutasya Dharmasya Sukhas Aikantikasya. I am the basic impersonal Brahman, which is the constitution, position, ultimate happiness, and which is immortal, imperishable, and eternal. So Krishna also concludes, many people idea behind Krishna, Brahman is there. Krishna said, Brahmanohi Pratishtha. Brahman is under my control. I establish and Brahman is an all-pervading energy of the Lord. Okay. Done. I finished the chapter. There's a special class. We are even working on a special class for children. Many of you see, if you come in the afternoon, evening session, morning, the children don't come, they don't get up so early. We are training thousands of children. So your children, if you want, we can train them also. Learning the shlokas, understanding the stories, imbibing some values. A lot of people requested previous batches. It's going extremely well. And not only I'll send you a registration of Bhakti Vriksha, I'll also give you a link for children's program. So you can at least make your children attend few sessions. You see if this is convenient. Same weekend time classes, they can learn. Okay, now we can have some questions. Yes. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, I'm not hearing anybody. Mics are on now.
Prabhuji.
Yeah. Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Nimi story, sir.
Nimi. Thing I want to talk about Nimi, not Nimi's story, about something he taught which is bewildering. He predicted appearance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Bhagavatam. Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishnam Sangopangasa Pashadam Yagnai Sankirtana Praya Yajantihi Sumedha Sadhu. I will talk about that someday. I need more time about that. It's a very revolutionary prediction. Lord Chaitanya will come, he said.
How can we transcend the mode, or how can we stay in mode of goodness? If a person is a mode of passion or a mode of ignorance, how can he remain in mode of goodness?
How do we change the modes? I tell you what all. Number one, we should have very good sadhana. First thing we should admit, there is some harassment of the mind. I have acquired infection. I agree that there is some problem. So suppose you go to doctor and doctor says, what's the problem? No, I'm fine. But the doctor says, get out. I cannot do anything. Even if he gives free medicine, you will not eat. If you're feeling, you're fine. You know, in college time, if you have seen, those when they're drinking, you can also know when they're tired. Those people who start shouting, abusing after they're drunk, they're tamasic people actually. And rasic people, when they get drunk, they start singing, ah, but they're rasic people. So, but don't do that experiment, but actually we can know even by that. Satic people, they feel very ashamed of that situation. They just lock their door and they don't become visible. They don't like that kind of, where they lose controlling of the mind. Drinking breaks your barriers to the mind and person becomes crazy. Okay, so that is another. So how do we change the modes? For very good sadhana, right? On first thing, you have to fix the time and attentively hear the name of the Lord and read Bhagavad Gita. What you're doing now should be a part of your life. Chanting, hearing about the Lord, worshipping the Lord. Different way, Navavidha Bhakti. Sadhana, good sadhana. Number two, you should be absorbed in your activities throughout the day. Number three, you should have very good relation with the people around you so you can stay very peaceful and don't make it disturbed. Number four, you should have a challenge every day. And keep it spiritual challenge and mental challenge or both, no problem. You have a business, some challenge, because you should be engaged. But at the same time, your division of the day should be 8 plus 8 plus 8. 8 hours of sadhana, 8 hours for the body, 8 hours for your body. Within that, you can manage. And then you see, you will be able to transcend. Tight. Your day should be tight. Relax, idle mind, devil's workshop, straight away. Moment I'm free, we only think about women and we think about nasty things. You know, keep yourself busy. Usko time bhi nahi milna chahiye. Maya means, excuse me, and you, what? And finished. There's no time for excuse. I don't have time. I don't have time. Sorry. Yeah, we know to procrastinate, no? Some unwanted desire, you know, mind is bringing because I'm infected. Yeah, tomorrow, no? Hey, postpone and let it go. Yes, Shravan ji, Hare Krishna. So four things were there. Number one, have a good sadhana. Number two, be absorbed in activity. Number three, have good relation with the people around you. Number four, have a challenge in front of you.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
And that's what I follow. That's what I told you. Somebody told me this and I practiced that.
Perfect, sir.
Yes, Shravanji.
Yeah.
That was you only. Yeah, take care. Any other question? Anybody? We still have 10 minutes.
In such cases, you can identify the activity because the whole experience that absorbing activity, which is the ignorance, then like then it might be difficult to be in mode of goodness. So how can identify the activity? How can we get absorbed in the activity?
They are working. That means you can mute others. Shahji, aapka voice clear nahi aaya. How do I manage? Yeah, Bhagavatam class in Telugu, my colleague takes every day in the night. I am requesting it in the morning also. His name is Shiva Sangan Kirtan Das. All of you have my email ID. Anytime, feel free. You have some question you cannot ask in public. You can ask privately. Right to my email. So he's taking class. The link I can send when you are asking email. Tulsi Physio. You are a physio, like a physiotherapist. He's a Chapandi.
Hare Krishna Guruji.
Yeah.
In the current scenario, in the current world, how can we find a guru?
See, first thing, you become a good student. Guru Krishna will take care.
Okay.
Say, you want to take admission and you are in which line? Engineering or medicine? Which line you are in?
Engineering.
So you want to take admission in IIT. First get qualified.
Okay.
I want to be in, today I think IIT Bombay is number one. I want to do computer science in IIT Bombay. Yeah, take care. First get qualified. Because you become a burden on the guru. Isn't it? Suppose, yeah. Because in spiritual line, there is no financial relationship. It's only a relationship of interest. Hana, he's taking commitment to say, take a commitment to get me an IIT seat. Okay. Now, if I'm studying 5 minutes a day, won't I kill you practically? You'll go mad. So you should be serious. So first thing is that before looking for a bona fide guru, first you become a bona fide student. Tasmat guru prapadeta jigyasu shreya uttamam. Now let me quote from the Shah. jigyasu shreya. We should be very inquisitive. Anna?
Okay.
Yeah, what is ultimate good? Not immediately, you know, some gratification. So first we become very serious spiritually. Krishna will help you. He's sitting in your heart. He'll help you develop faith in the right person. Oh, he will guide me properly. Guru is a guide. In our ISKCON movement, it's a dual system. Acharya Srila Prabhupada remains a founder Acharya. So it is based on Srila Prabhupada teaching. He's always everybody guru. Parallelly, one of his disciples will also act as a guru and give you diksha. So Prabhupada remains as a siksha and the guru, somebody, because all the books we're reading are from Prabhupada, correct? You see what all the books are written by Acharya. They are our also, he's also a guru. Plus, a guru will be somebody who will personally guide you. Diksha will give you initiation.
Because why I ask this question? Because whenever we study the spiritual or whenever we do these kind of practices, we get many questions. So sometimes I feel like, I mean, whom to ask these kind of questions? So that's where I got this question actually.
Yeah, a guru is a guide. See, formal Diksha Guru in ISKCON, we don't do immediately because person. This my whole Bhakti Vriksha program, what I told you, is taking to the Prabhupada Ashraya is just next to initiation. After that is Diksha.
Mm-hmm.
But suppose we take initiation to somebody and he doesn't follow anything, then I go to Narka, correct? The person who gives, or everybody goes to Narka. No? Mm-hmm. So there's a big responsibility in initiation. So we see the person is able to follow for some time, 1 or 2 years. Correct? Okay. A guru takes the karma of the disciple. If the disciple is not following, he has to go to hell along with it. Anna? While taking a task, he sees whether he's doing. Previously, your system was different. They come from good samskaras and training. No problem. They will do it. Anna? Today, nobody has any training. So we have to first 1 or 2 years prosharya, make him purified, and then he gives a commitment which actually he'll follow.
Hare Krishna, Guruji.
Hare Krishna. So don't worry. You become sincere, Krishna will, within your heart, will encourage you.
Okay.
And but you should also use your common sense, no? Suppose you take admission in a college, you see what is the placement. What is the placement? You use your common sense. That means you see here how many people have benefited, how many people's life are changed. Tips on maintaining good relationship. How do you relate to the Lord? Forget the people first. All your love, take out from everybody. Give it back, give it back. Put it on the Lord first. Through Lord, relate to everybody. You'll always will have good affection, compassion, because you're doing it as a matter of duty. And that, I tell you my relationship improved with everybody after I became devotee, including my parents.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yeah.
Prabhuji, how to remain in sattvic state throughout the day? Because without entering into the mode of rajasic state, so our livelihood will be very difficult. Because we have to earn money, we have to go to the office. And without entering into the mode of tamasic, because tamasic is the main factor to enter in the sleep mode. Because in the night we have to sleep. So in the night also, if you do sadhana in the sattvic mode, our life will get affected because it's a total package, sattvic, rajasic and tamasic. So we have to accept. So how we can separate sattvic from all the, from rajasic and tamasic? I heard that rishis will remain in sattvic state throughout the day without entering the mode activities and in a sleep state also. But in Kali Yuga, is it possible?
See, everything is possible, provided we're ready to follow. But the great acharyas, they are Krishna conscious. In their sleep time also, they are thinking of the Lord. Nitya Leela Prabhupada, always in the Lord's Leela. They have Leela Smaran. It's like a TV switched on. They can see the Leela of the Lord 24 hours. But that's very advanced. For us, at least remain a balanced property, our acharya should always be. Okay. Therefore, we have to sleep. Okay. We take bath when we get up. No, because too, I agree to what you say. Sleeping time, we are all in tamoguna. That is tamoguna. When you get up, what is the condition, everybody? That is tamoguna. So, but then you take bath. Even the place you sleep, we clean it. In a good samskaras, you fold the bed, throw it away, and even the floor you clean because you are in tamoguna lying there. So that's principle is same I told you. For Prabhupada always say, I have no new advice to give. chant the names of the Lord, and four regulated principles strictly follow. So there were five things is advised again and again, nothing new. Strictly chant attentively the 16 malas of Hare Krishna mantra and follow four regulated principles strictly. No intoxication, strict, be very strict with it. No gambling, no. You may earn some money in gambling, but the anxiety is not worth it. Intoxication is simply destroying your liver, kidney, and making your mind so weak. It is said when you intoxicate, you lose tapasya. That's what daru peete. If you remember in college, chal daru peete. Kuch bhi hua, chal daru peete. Your mind becomes so weak. Gambling, you become you lose your truthfulness. You start cheating people, lying because you want quick money. Illicit sex, you become dirty. Your mind, body becomes dirty. It's all your places.
Sorry, Bol Prabhu.
You lose.
Think materialistic and killing.
Hare Krishna, yes.
Hare Bol Prabhu. Prabhu, I hope I am able to phrase the question properly. So, are we saying in a way that Krishna is wholly, solely responsible for my spiritual possessions and my needs, but not at all responsible for my material possessions and needs?
You are asking a question. Let me think. Now, see, how can you say you are independent in any respect? The body has given you, the land has given you, food has given you. You have a freedom which he's asking you to use. He honors your freedom so much. He honors you a lot and is waiting. What's your name?
Anurag.
Anurag. He's waiting for Anurag to chant Hare Krishna. He's waiting. But he will not force you. He's requesting you. My dear Anurag, you can chant. Okay. So Anurag has to make this.
Okay. His
freedom is there. All the material is spiritual. Everything is free. Now you chant Hare Krishna and God happy or not, he is also free to accept your service or not service. But he is very merciful, always accepts, even though you do with a lot of faults. Freedom means relationships. They say, out of freedom you came for the class today, isn't it? And out of freedom you chose to ask me a question. Out of freedom I am replying. Freedom makes fun, no? Without freedom, what's life? Anna? But he honors your freedom. He honors your freedom. Even though we are very small, he honors your freedom. Yeah, okay. That's your choice. But in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, Arjuna, yathechasi, do what you want to do. Yathechasi tathakuru. I'm not going to force you. And Arjuna thinks for some time, and we will read the last instruction. Arjuna says, Karishya vacharam tava. I'll go to follow you. And that gives pleasure. A best teacher, Krishna plays as the best teacher. Arjuna, you decide. Right. And Arjuna says, I'll go to follow you. And that's his success. You know, Bhagavad Gita was a motivational speech which was successful.
Okay. Haribol.
Haribol. So all material, spiritual, we are totally dependent on the Lord. Totally dependent. But he is still allowing us to exhibit our freedom. See, maintenance God gives to everybody. Somebody is asking me this question. That is it like that? That father, mother, I don't have to pray. They give me breakfast. And this God, I have to pray. What kind of God is this? My parents are better than him. But for those things, you don't have to ask God because his animals are not going to temple. They are getting food. That thing is, we should not ask prayer. That prayer is not very appreciable. God, give me daily bread. Bread is giving to animals also. Pray for a relationship to him. That is within your freedom. He's not going to interfere. Oh, really? You want to relate to me? He'll embrace you very happily. He wants to. Father wants to talk. Krishna wants to talk to you more than you want to talk to him. More than you are interested, he's interested. But we are keeping away and he's silently watching. Okay, how can you be good with others around? We know they keep lying and gossiping. Please guide me. I'm cutting off such people and I have very few friends. Scared sometimes as we are far from a family. We are actually true. When you become spiritually serious, you lose friends. Every day will go away. When I was in college, he said, to dur raho. Because I had to every day, daru nahi pinega. He said, to dur raho. He pagal kar dega. The reality. You see, one good friend is better than 100 jokers. You come to Bhakti Vriksha, I'll give you a very good friend. You'll have very good friends. All are amazing people. And you can make some good friends.
Prabhuji, how do we surpass discouragement?
Now just completing on the Kavita's problem. See, you have to deal disinterested obligatory duty in your profession. Disinterested obligatory duty, even relating to the friends and friend, general friends. They'll be very happy with you. As a duty bound, you take care. You wish well for the whole world. Titikshavah, Karunikah, Surida Sarvabhutaram, Ajata Shatrava, Shantah, Shadava, Sadhubhushanam. People will love to be with you. Even you develop, when you take a spiritual life, one of the thing is that you become an amazing person. There is a result. You become totally free from all anxieties. First one, you have no anxiety. Number two, you become a wonderful person because Rajaguna Tamogana is washed away from your system. The process has to work. And then whole world will take to Krishna consciousness if you give a good example. We can speak big philosophy, but there is a change in character that encourages everybody. Oh my God, he totally changed. Can't believe it. So you don't worry. You will not lose friends. You will get good friends. Some jokers will go away, but you will get a lot of good friends. And you will have to handle people's difficulties without getting agitated. Guruji, language, Sanskrit, necessary to memorize shloka, not at all, not at all. Small children, it's okay. They can learn because they are at that age. At this age, you cannot learn that language. That's why I told you a very practical thing. See word-over-word meaning and translation. That's the best for you. That's enough. That's enough. Language is a very tough language. It takes 10 years to learn. We cannot begin now. If it is done in childhood, done now, it cannot be done. You can have 1 week, 2 week course, but just for pronunciation, that you can figure out by seeing the shloka word about meaning. Again, ISKCON, we don't focus on that at all. We tell them to start understanding the meaning, the explanation, and shlokas, see word about meaning. Around us to change or handle when they incline toward tamas guna. How do we request our...
surpass discouragement?
When people behave in such a tough world, they behave in a very discouraging. They
make fun of us.
So, see, point is, you should not be depending on. See what happens, just like parents today, they are not able to correct the children. Why? They themselves dependent on the relationship to be happy. You know, when they embrace the child and hold, that's their only satisfaction. But as a devotee, your happiness has already come by chanting Hare Krishna. You are very happy. Yeah, you do this again, I'll give you a slap. You don't mind if he sulks and sits in a corner for 2 days. You don't mind because your happiness is all, and it's good for him. Spare the rod, spoil the child. But today we don't have the mental strength. We cannot see face of a child being sad for 5 minutes because he is a source of happiness for us. Your happiness you already got by chanting, and then you cannot train him.
Brahmoji?
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, in the Navavidha Bhakti, I heard that Shravanam, Mananam, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Vandam, Vandiyam, Dasyam, Sakyam, and Atmanivedam in Navavidha Bhakti to come. But in the quiz, fourth chapter, it has mentioned Shraddha, Sadhu Sangha, Bhajan Kriya, Anartha Nivritti, Nishta, Ruchi, and Asakti, Bhava Prema. So it is not matching with the Navavidha Bhakti.
No. They are different things. One thing is steps in spiritual advancement. Other thing is ways of doing bhakti. Both are different things altogether. Just like you came to the class. You came to the class today, correct? You're understanding? You came to the class. That is Shravanam. No, that is Shraddha. There is something in it. Let me go. Correct? Then Sadhu Sangha.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Then Bhajani Kriya. I said you chant Hare Krishna. That's the only thing I have to. Then Anartha Nivritti, your unwanted desire vanish away. Then Nishtha, you develop firm faith. Because when unwanted desires are removed, you develop firm faith. Yeah, the process is working for me. Then Ruchi, then you feel so much taste in chanting. Then affection for the Lord, Asakti. Then Bhava, Prinivini, love for God, and Prema, love. There are the different stages of spiritual advancement. Navavidha Bhakti is 9 ways you can associate with the Lord. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam, Archanam. 9 ways you can serve. Like Archanam is happening now. You all can see. It's Archanam. And they are doing Kirtanam also. Anna?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Chalo. Chalega, thank you very much. You're all wonderful devotees. So we have, don't worry, we have 4 more days. 15, 16, 17, 18. And chapters are very short. We will get a lot of time. Today I spent a lot of time introducing you about Bhakti Vriksha. So I think that's also good. Orientation was needed. Hare Krishna. Thank you, everybody. I hope all of you come to Bhakti Vriksha which starts after this, from next, just on a weekend, 1 or 2 hours, I think should be possible for all of you. That will keep alive all the knowledge you learned also. Hare Krishna. Thank you, everybody.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. I'm joining the aarti now. If you have time, you're welcome. Okay? Then 8 o'clock is Bhagavatam class.